are preparing for any competitive examination, one of the very important chapter that is profit and loss. And here in this chapter, if you go through some core basic ideas, a very complex question can be solved out in a very short period of time. So welcome all of you in EduClub for you. And today in this video, we are discussing about profit and loss. And I'll give you some ideas by using or by implementing those ideas. You can find out the answers. There is no need of pen and paper for this. Or only the calculation part is required. Okay, but at the beginning, we'll try to know about the terms that we are using related to profit and loss. I hope all of you knowing about it, but still, it's need only 1 minute. So let us try. One is CP, means cost price, SP, selling price, MP, mark price, P for profit, L for loss. Sometimes that 10p is also called least price. Okay. And we all know that profit is the motto of business. So selling price always more than the cost price. It may be possible that there should be some losses, but in most of the cases, selling price is more than the cost price. When there is profit, selling price is more than cost price. And if any discount is given, then obviously mark price is greater than the selling price. Okay. Now, the first thing which one is very important in profit and loss is cost price. Whenever we try to find out profit percent or loss percent, find it, cost price is always at the base. You can never use selling price or mark price, only the cost price. If profit percent, profit divided by cost price into 100. You need loss percent, loss divided by cost price in 200. So, for profit percent or loss percent, cost price is always the base. This is point one. Now, point two. Anytime, never use the selling price. Means, selling price should always express in the terms of cost price if there is any profit or loss percent, and it can express in the terms of mark price if discount is given, because discount is always calculated on mark price. Okay, now let us suppose you are having 20% profit. You take the cost price as 100%. So selling price is what? 100% plus 20% of 100% means 120% of CP. So instead of SP, we can write down SP equals to 120% of CP. So there is no need to write down SP. Instead of SP, 120% of CP. Let us suppose there is 30% loss. So here in place of SP, we can write down 100 minus 30, 70% of CP. If there is 40% discount, discount is given on mark price. So we can take the mark price as 100% here. So here SP can be expressed as 60% of mark price. Okay. So, while solving the questions, avoid to write down selling price. Consider it in terms of cost price or in terms of mark price. Okay? Now, next one. If any time article per rupee is given, let us suppose 12 lemons per rupees 1, or 20 mangoes for rupees 100, or 10 oranges for rupees 50, like this, articles per rupees, if the data is given like this, then try to find out by using reverse method. I'll give example on this onwards. But mind it, if in the question it is given articles per rupee, then find out through the reverse multiplication method. Quite easy. You can find out instantly. Okay, now, for any article, if both the selling price are equal, let us suppose here selling price is X rupees and in the second article selling price is also X rupees. But in the first article, we are having P% profit. In the second article, we are having P% loss. Means profit percent equals to loss percent. If this type of question given, overall, every time there is loss. And here the loss percent is what? This P square divided by 100. If let us suppose we are having A percent profit and in the second we are having A percent loss, then your loss percent equals to what? A square divided by 100. Okay? Next is, let us suppose a trader cheated the customer in weight. Okay. So let us suppose instead of 1 kilo, he providing less than 1 kilo, means 960 gram, 970 gram, 980 gram, whatever that may be. Let us suppose X gram being cheated. Okay. So how will find out that cheating weight divided by real weight into 100. This is the profit percent. Okay. Cheating weight divided by real weight. Means the weight that he provide. Let us suppose, I give you an example here. 40 grams instead of 1 kilo, he provide 40 grams less. Means 960 grams. What is the profit percent? So cheating weight is what? 40 gram he cheated. Out of 960 into 100. This is the profit percent he is having. Okay? Let us suppose somebody is giving successive discount. First he providing 20%, onwards 30%. Again, let us suppose onwards another 20% or 30 or 40%, whatever that may be. So, by using successive percentage method, we can get the flat discount at a time. Let us suppose first we provide 20%, onwards 30%. Means, what is the final discount or flat discount that we have? We can go through successive percentage method. This is one method. Or we can provide through a simple calculation. Let us suppose the price is 100. Mark price is 100. He is giving 20% discount, means now it reduced to 80. Then again 30% means 30% of 80. Not of 100. 30% of 80 means 24. 24 less. So 56 rupees. Final price. So discount is what? 44. Okay, this is 44% discount. So these are the core basics of profit and loss. In upcoming videos, we try to find out the answers of complex questions. But here are some basic questions we are discussing. Let us suppose, question number one. A trader listed the mark price 60% above the cost price. Now the question is, what is the maximum percentage of discount that he can provide without suffering any loss? So here we can take the cost price as 100. He listed above 60%. Means 100 plus 60, 160 is the mark price. If the mark price is 160 and according to this question the trader haven't suffered any loss, means he can provide maximum 60 rupees as discount. So 60 rupees discount can be provided out of 160. But we need in percentage. So in 200, 60 divided by 160 in 200. 60 divided by 160 means 3 by 8th. Means 37.5%. So maximum 37.5% discount can be given. Okay, try another one. Let us suppose an article sold at rupees 680 and thereby the trader is suffering a loss of 15%. Now the question is, at what price he should sold it so that he will gain 35%? So how will find out? Consider it in CP. If he having a loss of 15%, your selling price is what? 85% of CP. And if he need 35% profit, selling price is what? 135% of CP. So here 85% is given. We have to find out 135%. So 680 divided by 85 into 135. 1080. So if he sold at rupees 1080, he makes a profit of 35%. Okay. There is no need to find out the cost price. Directly we can find out the selling price. Okay. Now I'll give one question. You try to solve it and write down in the comment box. We'll provide you a very shortcut on that. Okay. You try and set the answer. Write down the question. Look at the screen. A trader, let us suppose he purchasing cricket bats for rupees 300 each. And he can provide one bat free if somebody purchases 5. Means one bat free for every 5 number of bats. But he also wants to make a profit of 30%. Now you have to find out what is the selling price for each bet. Okay, write down to us. We will go through your answer and onwards I will provide you some shortcuts. Watch our next video on profit and loss. Till then, thank you.